This video is brought to you by Skillshare, an online learning community for creators where millions of people come together to take the next step in their creative journey. Skillshare has thousands of classes with a huge range of subjects. Want to learn some illustration skills? Sure, why not? Skillshare's got you covered. Video production? Absolutely. Crafts? Yes, they've got that too. Like I said, it's very diverse. Beginner or pro, Skillshare has a class to suit you. As long as you're curious and ready to learn, you're good to go. Me, I've taken a couple of courses these last few months. One was all about productivity, squeezing as much as possible from each day. We've all got the same 24 hours. I just wanted to use mine better. That was from a chap called Thomas Frank, who's also a YouTuber, by the way. Then I dove into another course, which sort of expanded on a particular element of productivity, email management. That's called Email Productivity, Work Smarter with Your Inbox by Alexandra Samuel. And I'd also recommend checking that one out. So yes, Skillshare, just go do it. It's super affordable, especially compared to an in-person class. It's less than $10 a month when you get an annual subscription. Check out the link below and let's get into it. I don't know if you've ever thought about it, but developing a new airplane model is probably one of the most complex business tasks that you can find. Difficulties involved in the process aren't only related to the enormous technological requirements of today's airplanes, but also with the strict regulations to which they have to adhere. Regulations that, at times, may clash with the delivery dates of new aircraft. And that seems to be the case of the infamous Boeing 737 MAX, which was put into commercial service back in May of 2017. We're talking about an airplane model that was created to replace the current 737 next generation models and compete against its European equivalent, the Airbus A320neo. Both planes, the 737 MAX and the A320neo, are part of a new fleet of more efficient, quieter, and less polluting planes. However, it could be that the American aircraft manufacturer Boeing has made a huge mistake in its business strategy simply by not launching them in time to be able to compete with Airbus. Because the fact of the matter is that Airbus got there first, launching its A320neo model a year and a half earlier than Boeing in January 2016. What's more, it could have been this rush to release the plane which caused two terrible aviation disasters that are so fresh in our minds. Just a year after the 737 MAX entered into service on October 29, 2018, Lion Air Flight 610 crashed shortly after taking off from Soekarno Hatta Airport in Jakarta, Indonesia. The flight was full, and none of its 189 passengers survived. But if it seems strange for a new plane to crash, it had only been in use for just under 3 months, alarms really started going off shortly after. On March 29, 2019, another Boeing 737 MAX 8, owned by Ethiopian Airlines, also crashed shortly after taking off from Bole Airport in Ethiopia. We're talking about two very similar incidents which happened during the same stage of flight, during takeoff, and with the same plane model each time. In just a few months, the new and dazzling Boeing model had claimed 346 lives. Faced with such a situation, both the United States' Federal Aviation Administration, the FAA, and all other agencies around the world ordered the immediate grounding of the entire 737 MAX fleet. Within a few hours, every single airplane of this particular model was parked up at airports around the world without any idea of when they would be able to fly again. Imagine the chaos. Tens of thousands of plane tickets just had to be cancelled. And what had been expected to be something temporary is still going on today because these planes still haven't been given the green light to fly. And now, given these facts, it's time to ask a few questions. What caused these two flights to crash? How and why was the operation of an airplane that had these problems approved? What are the repercussions of this disaster for Boeing and the airlines that bought this model? Well, listen up.
They're trying to pretend that they're very safety conscious and now they're going to be ultra safety conscious, and it doesn't fly. No one buys it.
An unsafe safety system?
To understand quickly what happened to the 737 MAX, we need to know the main changes made from the previous model, the 737 Next Generation. The new MAX planes were equipped with completely new engines, which were much more efficient, quieter, and much larger. Due to the size and weight of the new engines, Boeing had to ensure that they didn't touch the ground under certain circumstances, since the 737's belly is much closer to the ground than its European counterpart, the A320. If you don't believe me, take a look at this image of a Boeing 737NG, the previous model, alongside an A320. Many of you might be wondering, but Simon, is this really all that important? Well, yeah. To incorporate the new 737 MAX engines, two solutions had to be devised. First, create a new landing gear system so that the plane is further from the ground when landing. Second, and here comes the problematic part, they had to place the engines at a more advanced and raised position, slightly ahead of the wings. This leaves additional space from the ground. And this completely changed the airplane's lift capacity and its center of gravity. What this means is that when you change an airplane's center of gravity and the lift force at the same time, it's much more prone to stall during initial takeoffs and climbs. So, what exactly is a stall? Well, in a stall situation, the plane loses lift because it doesn't have enough speed to climb. And when that happens, when a plane goes into a stall, it starts to fall like a lead balloon. Now, this in itself isn't new. On the contrary, it's quite well known, and pilots are trained to correct for it. The fact is that to solve this design problem, which makes the 737 MAX prone to stalls, Boeing created a system called MCAS, Maneuvering Characteristics Augmentation System. So, to prevent the plane from falling, this system automatically corrects the plane's nose if it detects a possible stall during the climb. But how does it work? Well, you see, the most common way to get out of a stall is to lower the nose of the airplane, regain speed, and recover the lift. Therefore, the system would force the plane to descend in advance to try and avoid stalling. The problem was that sometimes it did it too soon and without sufficient height for that correction, and with poor communication with the aircraft's external sensors. Basically, the software was pushing the plane downwards. What happens next? Well, you already know. This was precisely what happened to both of the flights that crashed. Now, many of you might be thinking, okay, but if we know about this design weakness, the pilots must have known before flying these planes, right? Well, no. Many pilots of this plane model didn't even know that this system existed, and many others didn't know how to deactivate it because the MCAS system works even when the autopilot is disconnected. And here is where a complicated story about safety, transparency, and the conditions in which this aircraft was approved begins.
The disaster have been avoided.
This is like a movie plot. In recent months, news reports and documents that point to a possible lack of supervision by the US FAA in the approval of the Boeing 737 MAX have kept turning up. This adds fuel to the fire that Boeing may have been negligent in their rush to launch the plane. We only need to take a look at the internal emails of employees where they said things like this. It's a plane designed by clowns and supervised by monkeys. Would you put your family on a plane trained by the MAX simulator? I wouldn't. So, could the two MAX incidents have been avoided? Sadly, recent information suggests that, yeah, they could have been. Peter DeFazio, head of the Transportation Committee of the U.S. House of Representatives, says that his panel has collected more than 500,000 documents, emails, and interviews shared between Boeing and the FAA that points to a break in the safety culture between Boeing and the FAA.
Our investigation has revealed that many of the FAA's own technical experts and safety inspectors believe FAA's management often sides with Boeing rather than standing up for the safety of the public.
You don't need to be a genius to notice that what DeFazio means is that Boeing and the FAA collaborated to relax the requirements and thus accelerate the approval times for this model. But why? Well, as we said previously, the A320neo may have had something to do with it. But it doesn't end there. There's much, much more. After the first accident, that of Lion Air, the FAA concluded that the MCAS was the cause of the incident, and anticipated that if it were not solved, the same system failure could result in up to 15 similar accidents during the lifespan of the fleet. In other words, the 737 MAX was much more likely to crash than all the other Boeing models currently in service put together. That was the prediction, and actual events have shown us that the reality could have been much, much worse. If we consider this model's short period of activity, the data is devastating. With a simple cross-multiplication, the 737 MAX, the new Boeing star, would have had two catastrophic accidents per every million flights, while, for example, its predecessor, the 737NG, had a statistic of one accident every 10 million flights. That's 20 times fewer. To give you an idea, the current average number of fatal accidents of all airline manufacturers worldwide is one every 3 million flights. That's 6 times lower than the MAX. So basically, the MAX would have had more accidents than a paper airplane. Boeing manufactured a flawed plane. By now, that seems to be clear. And that gives rise to another question. Would you get on a plane like that? Well, be careful, because the American FAA thought differently, at least after the first accident. After discovering the tremendous deficiencies of the MCAS system, which literally pushed the Lion Air plane to the ground, this agency decided to lay all the blame on the crew. In addition, the FAA gave Boeing 7 months to modify and install a new version of the MCAS without errors in all the existing MAX aircraft around the world. That is, Boeing was allowed to apply a temporary patch until it resolved the design flaw. Logistically, this patch couldn't be applied to all the airplanes at once. So, the crews of the non-updated airplanes were warned that they were flying in airplanes with an MCAS system that could crash the plane into the ground. And with that warning, and some training which would supposedly help them override this system in dangerous circumstances, that is, in the case the system forced the airplane downwards again when it was still too close to the ground, the FAA believed that those airplanes could remain in service. Doesn't sound like the best decision ever, right? And, well, obviously, it wasn't. Only 3 months later, the Ethiopian plane crashed, and it was then faced with such a scandal and discredit that the FAA was forced to ground the entire 737 MAX fleet right up until today.
We're going to be issuing an emergency order of prohibition to ground all flights of the 737 MAX 8 and the 737 MAX 9.
Unfortunately, the damage had already been done.
FAA failed to properly review 737 MAX's jet's anti-stall system. JATR findings, Reuters.
And now the question is, until when? When is this plane going to fly again? Well, at first it was said that a relaunch was imminent, that everything would be fixed by January 2020. Then they said that it would be ready for April. Now they are saying that it should be done by June or July, and others state that it'll be done by the end of 2020. What's more, many analysts consider that given the huge modifications that would have to be made, recertification would take even longer. Meanwhile, Boeing and the companies that bought this model are suffering huge financial consequences. Consequences that we're now going to share.
The 737 MAX hemorrhage.
The 737 is Boeing's star model. It has been the best-selling aircraft in the world since the first batch was launched in the 1960s. Since then, more than 10,500 aircraft of this model have been built. That's why it's no surprise that Boeing had accumulated more than $50 billion in orders for the 737 MAX by the time the whole fleet was grounded. $50 billion that is now in limbo. Orders and purchasing options have collapsed, and airlines and intermediaries are throwing themselves at Airbus to get planes that can be flown as soon as possible. And Airbus currently has more orders than it can handle, because at this point, even if the 737 MAX were reintroduced, it isn't clear if the model would have the success of previous 737 models. Clearly, many passengers now perceive it as a structurally unstable plane. It's not really surprising, is it? And that explains news headlines like this.
United says it will allow passengers to avoid 737 MAX flights, CNN.
At the moment, the US manufacturer has already lost at least $9 billion from this crisis, and that estimate could be much more, upwards of $30 billion.
Boeing suspends production of 737 MAX model involved in fatal crashes, The Guardian.
It's the first time in 20 years that Boeing has stopped production of a model. What's worse is that the manufacturer has at least 400 already manufactured aircraft that cannot be delivered. They don't even have the space to store them, and some are even parked in the employee parking lot at Boeing. And of course, this decision doesn't only affect Boeing and the 12,000 workers at the Renton factory which builds the 737 MAX, it also affects 600 much smaller suppliers that could have serious financial problems. The domino effect could be hard for the US economy. There are thousands and thousands of jobs at stake here. As you can imagine, this also exerts enormous pressure on the FAA's decisions when authorizing an aircraft to enter service as soon as possible. And this may explain why some air safety agencies, such as Europe's EASA, have begun to mistrust it, which was revealed for the first time when it broke a tradition of bilateralism. A tradition whereby if the FAA approved a Boeing model, it was automatically approved by the EASA and vice versa regarding Airbus aircraft approvals. However, now it seems that this is no longer going to happen.
European air regulators break from FAA on 737 MAX timeline, Wall Street Journal.
By now, 2020 is a mystery. Can you imagine what would happen if the 737 MAX continues to be grounded? What would this mean for Boeing? And not to mention the serious problems that the company could be having with the development of its new star model, the 777X, whose launch has been delayed.
Cargo door explosion ends tests on Boeing 777X, Reuters says. Bloomberg. Boeing 777X fuselage reportedly split during September's stress test.
The question that more and more analysts are now asking is, could the case of the 737 MAX be just the beginning of a large-scale problem in Boeing's developments and production lines? Could 2020 be an even worse year for the US company? It's hard to know for sure, but it doesn't look good, but we'll be on the lookout. But now, what do you think? Do you think that its entry into operations by June or July is realistic, given that Boeing paralyzed its production in December? Would you be brave enough to fly on this model of plane? Well, leave your answer in the comments below. And I really do hope you enjoyed this video. Please do hit that like button if you did. Don't forget to subscribe. Also, check out our friends at the Reconsider Media podcast who provided the vocals in this episode that were not mine. And as always, thank you for watching.
If you want to learn more about politics and world affairs and hear some more of my lovely voice, come check out the Reconsider podcast, where we don't do the thinking for you. Find Reconsider at www.reconsidermedia.com or on Apple or Google Play or your favorite podcatcher.
We're going to be issuing an emergency order of prohibition to ground all flights of the 737 MAX 8 and the 737 MAX 9.